Passwords suck. They're annoying to remember, you need way too many of them, and it seems like we can never quite make them strong enough. Why can't we solve this problem? Well, we can. Sort of. In this video, we're going to change how you think about passwords, and we'll walk through the simple steps that you need to take to keep your passwords safe and sound. Everything important about passwords boils down to one simple equation, n to the r. This equation tells us the number of permutations or possibilities for a password. N is the number of things to choose from for R positions in our password. The bigger either number gets, the harder it is for someone, like a hacker, to guess our password. And you've probably memorized these rules for making a strong password. It's at least 8 characters long, has at least a capital letter, one number, and one symbol, and you need to change it every 90 days. The goal of these rules was to increase the value of n in our equation, to make sure that everyone is using more characters on the keyboard than just small A to Z. The problem is that those rules actually accomplish the opposite thing. They make passwords weaker. Those common password rules make your password weaker because they don't account for the most important factor in any password, your ability to remember it. If you can't remember a password, it's useless. Making matters worse, you don't just have to remember one password, but dozens and dozens of them. More on that in a little bit. For short-term memory, it turns out that humans can only typically remember about 7 random things. So while our equation of n to the r tells us the number of all possible passwords, that makes a big assumption that we will choose one randomly. We don't. Especially when those common password rules are in place. You know it, I know it, so let's just call it out. We all have passwords that look something like this one. See, it's super clever because I have more than one capital letter in addition to my symbol and number. I can remember it, and at 14 characters long, it's crazy long. Case closed. Except that now we're actually breaking our formula. My cool password breaks our formula because while it accounts for my shoddy memory and it meets those common password rules, it doesn't factor in how hackers and cybercriminals actually try to guess our passwords. Let's do a little thought experiment. If I pick a number between 1 and 10 and I ask you to guess it, how would you order your guesses? Would you randomly pick a number until you got to mine? If you approach the problem logically, you might start at 1 and work your way to 10, or maybe you'd be clever and start at 10 and work your way down. All of these methods have the same mathematical probability of guessing the answer right. This is one of the reasons that we think my cool password is a good password, but these methods don't take into account how we think. It turns out that if you're trying to guess my number, you'd have better luck starting with 7, then 3, then 8, 4, 5, 9, 6, 2, 1, and finally 10. That's the order of our favorite numbers according to a 2015 global survey. And while it's not science that I would bank on, it does highlight the key point. People have preferences and biases that you can bet on. The odds are good that I'd pick a 7 or a 3 for you to guess. Now this applies directly to passwords. As a hacker, I know that people can't remember random jumbles, so instead of guessing every possible combination of letters and numbers and symbols, I'm going to use what's called a dictionary attack. That's when the hacker tries to guess your password using actual words and common misspellings, like adding a number. Now, this is a much faster way, as there's a strong chance that I'll guess your password well before I work my way through all the possibilities. That's why these common password rules actually make your password weaker. Due to how our minds work, they guide us to choose easier to guess passwords. Knowing what we know about how our mind works, we can easily create a better password. Up to now, we've been thinking about the n in our equation as all of the possible letters, numbers, and symbols. What if, instead of those characters, we thought about n as the number of actual words in our passphrase? Now, this holds true for all languages, but we're going to use English here as the example. There's approximately 171,000 English words in common use today, and our brains are wired to remember words as one thing, which means stringing a bunch of them together can give us a really long password that's easy to remember. But will it be strong enough? Well, our friend n to the r will tell us. When using the old rules, the total number of possible passwords after accounting for our bad memories and habits ends up being around 53 trillion. Now that's a ridiculously massive number, and it feels like it would be impossible to guess those passwords, but it's actually not that hard. Before we explore why that holds true, let's calculate the passphrase possibilities. If we select 4 random English words, there's about 855 quintillion permutations. If 53 trillion was ridiculous, 855 quintillion is absurd, and that's great news for our password, especially when hackers can use readily available computers to try hundreds of millions of guesses per second. If passphrases are super strong, why aren't we using them everywhere? Well, the answer is as obvious as it is frustrating. Complex technology takes time to change, and if a problem isn't seen as absolutely critical, it's pushed aside for a later that never really comes. Passwords can be made stronger by simply picking a more complicated password. We know that because of our friend N to the R. That we can't remember those complex passwords, let alone dozens of them, doesn't really factor in that often. And even in systems where the team puts their foot down and they say, this is critically important, we need to fix this now, those fixes can take months before rolling out. Besides, there is another way of making an old style or any password even stronger. Add another password to it. You may have heard of two-factor or multi-factor authentication. This is where you enter your password and you also have to enter a temporary code to gain access. You usually get that code either through a text message or an app on your smartphone. This makes it a lot harder to gain access to your account. Even if a hacker has your password, they will need your phone in order to gain access. So why isn't this everywhere, you ask? Well, it's gaining traction, but it still asks people to do more while logging in, and that usually leads to problems. However, when possible, you really should be using two-factor authentication. It's a minor inconvenience that's a massive boost to your security. We know that it's hard to remember one password, let alone dozens of them. You should be using a different password for every app and site you log into. The reason? Well, it's to reduce the impact of one of those sites getting hacked. One of the first things that cybercriminals do after stealing a bunch of usernames and passwords is try them on other sites to see where they work. And they often do work on those other sites. Using a different password on every site is a smart way to protect all of your online accounts. But that creates the very real challenge of trying to remember all these passwords. How on earth are we going to tackle that one? Well, we're going to solve it by handing it off. The solution is a tool called a password manager. It manages our passwords for us. The idea is actually pretty simple. A password manager is an app that securely creates and stores our passwords for every account that we have. It can create truly random, very strong passwords and keeps them safe in its vault. And when the time comes for you to log in, you open up your password manager and it will log you into the site for you. The process is usually seamless, but even when it breaks down, you can simply copy and paste the password from the password manager. Logging in from your phone or tablet? Not a problem. Good password managers offer the app on most platforms and automatically and safely synchronize your data to all of your devices. I've been using one called 1Password for over a decade, and it's always worked well for me and my family. The small monthly fee is reasonable for the safety that it provides, and if that's not your thing, there's a number of commercial and open source options available. Pick one that works on your devices and where the user experience works for you. The important thing is that you use a password manager. Which one is far less important? Now, a password manager itself is actually protected by a password. Here's where our complete solution is really going to start to come together. All reasonable password managers follow the latest guidelines and let you make gigantic passwords. We're going to take advantage of that and create a passphrase made up of four or more truly random words. And the more words you can get in there, the better. And if you're feeling feisty, why not add in a symbol or a number too, just for fun? Now that passphrase is going to be used with our password manager and only with our password manager. We're then going to let the manager create some truly random, large, gibberish passwords for each and every site and app that we use. Now, this sets up the odd situation where you won't even know your Facebook, Google, or Twitter password, but hey, that's one less place that it could leak from. Now, when visiting these sites or using these apps, we'll log into our password manager, and then it will log into the site for us. When creating a new account, the password manager is going to step up and provide a new, super strong password too. It's remembering all these passwords for us, which works around the limitations of our memory. Now, at each and every site, we're maximizing the password strength while still making things easy for ourselves. But we will add a tiny bit of friction back by using two-factor authentication everywhere it's offered. It's a minor inconvenience that offers a huge security boost. Now, there's a lot of things associated with passwords that are completely out of your control. How your brain works, how aggressively hackers go after your passwords, how the systems that are asking for those passwords handle them in the back end, and more. Now, this workflow, it offers the best solution to a frustrating problem. It makes it hard for hackers to guess our passwords by making sure that we're maximizing the impact of our friendly equation, N to the R.